God. And at that moment, that curse comes upon all of creation, sickness and disease. Death comes into the world. And Satan now has dominion and authority. Adam commits high treason. And as a result, surrenders his authority and dominion to Satan. And at that moment, man becomes cursed, becomes lost. The Bible says man is lost without hope, that he becomes a child of wrath. The Bible says he becomes a child of the devil, that you serve your father, the devil. At that moment, everything changed. It was an incredible moment in history in which everything looked like it was lost. All that God intended to happen looked like it went down the tubes. Looked like Adam messed it up big time. But God had a plan. Everybody say, but God. But God. God had a plan to redeem man. God's all-knowing. He knew from the very beginning. He knows the beginning from the end. He knew that man was going to mess up. And so he had a plan in order to redeem man back to himself, to get dominion and authority back. And that plan was his son, Jesus Christ. The Bible is all about the plan of redemption. If you really want to understand the Bible, it's really not that hard. It's very simple. It's really the story of redemption. From Genesis to Revelation is God's revelation of himself and his plan of redeeming God, redeeming man back to God. It's the scarlet thread that goes through the Bible, the story of Jesus, that Jesus would come and redeem man. And God sent his son at the right time, at the appointed time. When due season came, he sent his son as a seed, and Jesus came, and through his death, burial, and resurrection, he won the victory, and he got back what the devil had stolen. Yeah, shout to God. Hallelujah. And I'm going to show you from the Bible. First, turn over to Luke chapter 4. I want to give you one more verse that establishes the fact that Satan actually ends up with dominion and authority. Some people struggle with this. Some people really don't believe that's the case. They don't believe that God would allow Satan to take dominion and authority. But look at Luke chapter 4, and we see further evidence of that's exactly what happened in Genesis chapter 3. Luke chapter 4 is where Jesus is led out into the wilderness. He's now come into the earth. He's been born by the Virgin Mary. It's come to that appointed time, and God has brought forth his son. He's been brought into the earth, and about the age of 30, his ministry is about ready to start, and he's led out into the wilderness by the Spirit of God. By the Holy Spirit, he's led out into the wilderness. And when he gets out into the wilderness, he runs into the same devil that tempted Adam and Eve in the garden. That same slithering serpent that came and enticed Adam and Eve is now in the wilderness tempting Jesus. Look at verse 3. It says, and the devil said to him being Jesus, if you are the Son of God, command this stone to become bread. But Jesus answered him, saying, it is written. Everybody say, it's written. Man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word of God. Notice Jesus immediately comes against that temptation by the word of God. I want you to see something here that's important for us to understand. The devil has not changed. He's still going about trying to deceive people, just like he did Adam and Eve in the garden. He's not changed. He came into the garden. He said, did God really say? See, he's whispering those things in the ears of believers. Did God really say? He's always trying to sow seeds of doubt. Did God really say you could be saved? Did God really say you could be forgiven? Did God really say you could be healed? Did God really say he would direct you? Did God really say he would provide all your needs? Oh, no. And always then bringing forth that temptation to put a hook in you and put that bait before you and to hook you and to take you out of what God wants for your life. Nobody's immune from temptation. Notice Jesus himself is being tempted here in the wilderness, in the desert. Temptation will come your way, but God has equipped us and empowered us to resist temptation. Jesus is modeling it here. If temptation comes your way, if the enemy's whispering those seeds of doubt and putting those things in front of you, trying to entice you, you just say, it's written. It's written. The devil didn't stop there, though he tempts him with one more temptation. And here's what I want you to see. Verse 5, then the devil taking Jesus up on a high mountain, showed him all the kingdoms of the world in a moment of time. And the devil said to him, all this authority I will give you and their glory. For this has been delivered to me, and I give it to whomever I wish. Therefore, if you will worship before me, all will be yours. See, Satan has that authority and dominion, and he's offering it to Jesus. What authority and dominion does he have? The authority and dominion that Adam gave up in the Garden of Eden. Adam had the dominion and authority. Human race had the dominion and authority, but because of the sin of Adam, he gave it over to Satan. He lost dominion. And now Satan is in the wilderness tempting Jesus with this authority, with this power, this dominion. If it weren't so, Jesus would have known it. There would have been no temptation. But actually, the temptation wasn't to take the dominion and the power. The temptation was to bow down and worship the devil. That's what he wants. That's what got him kicked out of heaven. He wanted the worship. Let me tell you this. Only God deserves the worship. That's what Jesus answered here. Yeah, give him praise. He alone deserves all the praise. Jesus said, get behind me, Satan, for it's written, you shall worship the Lord your God, and him only shall you serve. He alone deserves the worship. It's written. Jesus knew the answer to that. We only worship him. But what I want you to see is that Satan had dominion and authority. But Jesus came to take that back. Look at Matthew chapter 28. Matthew chapter 28. This is after the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus. God's plan of redemption, God's plan to reconcile man back, was through his son Jesus. Jesus came to the earth, and the plan of redemption was for him to go to the cross and to take our place and receive the punishment, receive the judgment that we deserve for the sin that came upon the world because of the sin of Adam. And Jesus died on the cross. He was buried, but on the third day, he rose from the dead. His resurrection is proof that he's the Son of God. And when he was raised from the dead, it was a declaration to everyone that the devil had been defeated. Look at Matthew chapter 28, verse 18. And Jesus came and spoke to them, saying, all authority has been given to me in heaven and on earth. Go therefore and make disciples. Jesus is declaring at this moment in this time, I now have all authority, all power, all dominion. I now have it. What happened is through his death, burial, and resurrection, he defeated the devil and he took it back. That's why Jesus came. 1 John 3:8 says, for this purpose was the Son of God manifest, to destroy the works of the devil. Why did Jesus come? He came to destroy the works of the devil. And in Matthew 28, he gets up and he declares to them, I now have all authority, all dominion. I have all the power. He's declaring, I now have defeated Satan and taken back what he stole from Adam in the garden thousands of years before. And he's declaring it. Revelation 1:18. He says this. He says, I am he who lives and was dead, and behold, I am alive forevermore. And now I have the keys of death, hell, and the grave. Keys represent authority, power. Yeah, give God praise.